Jungle. Hello everyone, welcome to Wi-Fi Learn. We are seeing the circuit theory subject and we have seen some definitions of electrical circuit. In last video we have seen about the potential divider. In this video we can discuss about current divider. Current divider circuit have two or more parallel branches for current to flow through, but the voltage is same for all the components that present in the parallel circuit. So it is a parallel circuit with two resistance which is connected in parallel by using a common point. In the common point we are giving a supply of VS voltage. It can be either of battery or any energy source that will supply the voltage in a parallel circuit. So the current divider circuit are parallel circuit in which the source will supply the voltage and the current will start to flow from, assume it has a positive terminal and it is a negative terminal, the current will flow from positive to the negative and the current will divide accordingly to the parallel path that has been connected in the circuit. If it has number of parallel path, then the current would divide according to the parallel path that is present in the circuit. In a parallel circuit, all the components have their terminals connected together, sharing the same end. All the elements of the two terminals are connected to the common, sharing the two ends as a nodes. That is, here the resistance of this node and the resistance of this node are connected commonly to the positive terminal. Other end of the resistance R1 and R2 are connected to the negative terminal of the battery by sharing the common nodes. This connection results the current to be divided as to the parallel path that present in the circuit. However, the total current would be higher, but it has been divided as I1 and I2 to the parallel path that has been connected in the circuit. As we all know, the current in the parallel circuit would differ, whereas in the case of voltage would be same. It is common to the all the elements that present in the parallel circuit. So the current divider is a simple passive circuit. It is also formed by the passive element resistance R1 and R2. So it is termed as a simple passive element circuit. We have already discussed about the passive element. Check out the video in the playlist. That passive elements are the elements that consumes electrical energy or it does not change the shape of the electrical energy after passing through it. So it is a simple passive element circuit. This is a simple current divider formed by using the resistance. It is also termed as a resistive current divider. This circuit can also be termed as a resistive current divider. You can find the value of the current that is flowing through the particular resistance. That is, I1 is the current flowing through R1, I2 is the current flowing through R2. See, in this circuit the total current is divided as a I1 and I2 in the branches. So the total IT can be represented as sum of the I1 plus I2. According to Ohm's law, I1 can be represented by total supply voltage divided by the resistance R1. This is due to Ohm's law. And I2 can be represented as supply voltage VS divided by R2. I total cannot be given by supply voltage divided by R total or R equivalent. So we need to find the particular current value I2 or I1. We can find by using the current divider circuit. I2 can be represented by VS into R2. Right? From the basic total current value, we can take VS value as IT into RT. Right? So IT can be given as, substituting the value of VS here, we can take IT into RT divided by R2. This is the value of the current I2 that is flowing through the resistance R2. Even can also be written by using a symmetric equation, IT into total resistance divided by R1. So this is a current divider equation, I2 current through the resistance R2 is equal to total current into total resistance divided by R2. I1 is equal to this total current into total resistance divided by the resistance R1. We can further reduce as the total resistance in the parallel circuit, if two resistance R1 R2 present, can be given by product of R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is a equivalent resistance for the parallel circuit. So if you substitute this RT value in the current equation, so current equation I2 is equal to total current into R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into divided by R2. If you cancel this R2 and this R2, the current through the resistance R2 can be given by R1 divided by R1 plus R2 into total current. It states that the current through the resistance R2 is equal to total current into opposite resistance divided by the total resistance at present in the circuit. So the general equation can be given by Ix is equal to total current, that is It, opposite resistance of the X, opposite resistance divided by total resistance, add summation of the total resistance that present in the parallel circuit. We can find the current dividing equations for n number of resistance that is connected in parallel circuit. If these two resistance R1, R2 that is connected in parallel are equal, then the total current can be divided equally. If the total current is 10 amps, then the current through R1 and R2 would be 5 amps and 5 amps. So I1 would be 5 amps, I2 would be 5 amps if total current is 10 amps. If R1 and R2 are equal, then the current has been divided equally between the two branches. This current dividing equation can be found for conductance also. Conductance is a term that is opposite to that of resistance. Resistance resists the flow of current, conductance allows the flow of current. So, reciprocal of resistance is conductance. It is denoted as G. You can find the current divider in conductance. Conductance is a term that is inverse of the resistance. Resistance resists the flow of current, whereas in the case of conductance, conductance allows the flow of current. So, inverse of resistance is conductance. It is denoted as G. So in a parallel circuit, the equivalent resistance can be represented by R total is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Assume two resistances are connected in parallel. There can be n number of resistance also. So inverse of resistance can be represented as 1 by RT. 1 by RT is G, conductance, total conductance. So GT would be equal to G1 plus G2. G2 is the conductance of resistance R1, G2 is the conductance of this. Okay, this term. So total GT can be given by G1 plus G2. According to the current division rule, that the current through the first resistance R1, current through R1 can be represented by total current into total resistance divided by the that resistance R1, which we have found in last expression. We know that reciprocal of resistance is conductance GT. RT can be represented as 1 by GT. Similarly, 1 by R1 is equal to G1, 1 by G1 is R1. Substitute that, we'll get I1 is equal to IT into 1 by GT divided by 1 by G1. If you take reciprocal, we'll get as G1 divided by GT where I1. This is a current divider equation for conductance. Current divider equation can be represented by I1 current, this is equal to IT into G1 divided by GT. Whereas in the case of resistance, the current equation is I1 is equal to IT into RT divided by R1, opposite of the conductance. Here G1 by GT, here RT by R1. It is the difference between the conductance current divider equation and resistance current divider equation. So similarly, I2 current can also be given by total current into G2. Conductance of second element divided by total conductance. For resistance current divider, we have to take the reciprocal of this. So, IT into RT divided by R2. This is the current divider equation of the resistance. This is the current divider equation of the conductance. Jungle.